My name is Gidamlela Michael, and welcome to the part two of this video tutorial where we deal with the Node.js stack that we're given to start the .ng interns. Okay, so in the part one of the video, which the link is in the video description below, looked at user sign up. I'll just do a quick recap. We are actually looking at a task in which the interns were asked to build the backend architecture with Node.js and MongoDB. It's an online tutorial, so we expect that we have users that will sign up as students or as tutors. Then the tutors can be made admin. So we're able to undo the sign up, user sign up, and test it on Postman. And so we are going to be looking at the login now. Now, for every action you are going to be taking, you are either going to be retrieving data from your database, or you are going to be creating data in your database. When we did sign up, we actually created a data. So we created a user collection, and that's why here we are able to see user.save. So we created that in the database, and that and we performed some queries. Like here, we have to do user.find one to find if that user exists already in the database. So as we are trying to log in, we also be querying the database for the user data, and we will be updating the database, because we are going to be generating a new token, and then that should replace the token that is already in the database against the user. So let's just get right to coding. I'm expecting it, the details of the user. So as the user is applying for login, generally we know you only need your email and password to log in. So we'll be requesting the email and password. So let's get that using object destructuring email password. So we are getting it through object destruction from the request of body. Now, once we get this, we need to now query the database and check if there is a user that actually has these details. So we just do the same thing we did there. Const user. Pardon. But in this case, I can just say, I can just change the name of the variable. So we have that user is await user.find on email. So you are looking for a user with the email that we just got through that structure. And then if user is not found, so if user is not found, then it should give us an error. So we can just say return. The status 400. The send email address not found. You can just be nice and do something like, please check your login details. And maybe that is not found is actually enough, but sometimes you can just be you can you might want to be more detailed to just provide the data the user with better information. Okay, so you take care of the fact that if we cannot find the user, then you should send an error. Now, if the user is found, then we want to check if the password is the same as the password provider in the database. So we can just do const value pass, like we can pass a variable that we want to do as value pass, like value password. So this is a bcrypt operation. So we just say await bcrypt dot compare. So we are comparing the password provided to the password in the database. So since you have found user already, remember that we have user here. So if user has been found, so pick the password of the user. So we have const value passwords await bcrypt dot compare. So it compares both password. And if the two passwords, if the password that is supplied matches the password in the database, it would return true. Value password return would be true. And if the password does not match, value pass would be false. And then you can say if it's not true, then you should return. Let me just copy this and paste. So, our details will be the message will be different. We can just say incorrect password provided. Please try again. Or you can customize it as you like. Some sites will just do something like, oops, authentication credentials are incorrect or something. So it all depends on what you like. So from there, if you can scale through this, it means that the user is found and then the valid password. So if the user is found and then we have a valid password, then we should create a token. So we are creating a token, and then we have access token is JWT dot sign. So in this case, I want the access token to take more credentials, so I can passing the ID, I have the email ID, and then the role of the user. So role. So if the user is a tutor or a student, then I will use that to generate the token. The token is still the same, star.ng, and since it's signed, just logging in. You can see it expires in 1 hour, so within an hour it's active for just an hour. Okay, so we have to update the data in the database with the new token. So we can just use Mongo's find one and update. So we can do something like const result equals to await. There is we are still using our user model, so we are doing user dot find by ID and update. So we are finding by ID and we will update, and find by ID and update will require you to pass in the ID of the user underscore ID, so and then the data you want to update to. So I want to update the token to be access token that we just generated. And then this would take some options. If I run without putting the option, it will give a deprecation warning. So use find and modify. You can just say this is true. So we have a sorry, it's you set it to false rather not to. So and then there is another option. You can just say new true. So new true. So we have that done, and if this is successful, then at least it will give the result of this query, it will pass it to the variable result. And if we have this successful query, and it was able to update the token as we wanted, then you should send a successful message. So I can just copy this and then come here. I have but no, what we are just going to do is this person is logging is successful. The message I'm going to pass will be different now. So we can just say login successful. And then you don't need to pass the details of this again. You just need the ID. So the ID will be user result.id. So remember that we are actually getting the result of our query, so result.id. And then let's check if we are actually getting the token as well. So the token will be result.token. Okay, so this is the message you expect if there is a successful update. I can just do a 200 rather than a 201. So also it's important that you can as well just tell the request to be sent along with a particular header. So the header would be the X access token, X up token. Pardon me. So it will be X up token, and then it will take the value of access token that is generated, then dot status. So we have it takes the header X up token, and that is the access token being sent. The status the same. So if a user is logging in, you this token follows that request, and then it can be retrieved for any reason or for any purpose you want. And once you are retrieving, you can use it as you wish. We'll see how we can use that in authorization when we want to. Maybe some parts that you don't want people to go. So as long as probably it's an admin part and you don't want a tutor to access that part, then you can use the token for authorization. Okay, so we have a response dot. So that's what I copied earlier. So we have this. So if there is any error, this will catch it. And then we can log in. Now remember that we don't just want to log in. We also want to ensure that we can access that route. So we come here and we do login is also a post route. So router.post login. Then the same user controller dot user login. You can see that it's actually seeing the methods of user controllers. So we have that. Then I'm already using it in app So it's the same route that is being required. So I do not need to do anything here, basically. So let's save. Let's save the two files together. And then let's see if we have errors, no errors encountered. So let's go over to Postman. Yeah, I think I. Okay, let's try to. This is a register, this is a sign up allowed. So let's just try to register a user as a tutor. So it requires password. And then I can just say this is then just put anything there. Okay. Because I'm registering the person as a tutor, I can just have a role. Sorry, what role? So we have tutor. Okay. So this person is registered as a tutor, and I can send. Okay, sorry. I think I have to restart Postman, or let me see if I can copy this data. It's not allowing any operation, actually. Okay, I could use the keyboard shortcut. So let me restart this. Apologies, let me quickly do that. So why Postman is coming up? I can just quickly run through what we did with login. So for login, we wanted to ensure that a user exists already. So the user that is supplying whatever data, we want to ensure that the user exists. So we had to do a query of the database and check if the user exists. Now, if the user does not exist, we expect that the O code should end there and return this. If the user exists and did not provide a correct password, then the code should end there and return this message. Now, if both conditions are met, then it should create a new token and update whatever token the user has in the database and update it to this. So we are sending that token as a header, which can be retrieved later. And then the status 200 of send. We are sending the success message, and we are saying that login is successful. Then, if there are any errors that we did not cater for here, maybe an error with the database, an error with the server or something, then it will be caught here. So, let me check if. Okay, so. We have it up already. I go to body. Let me paste what I cut earlier. So, let me try to sign this person up. So, you see, startengine@gmail.com is already registered. So, I have to. Change, let me just do start@gmail.com. So the registration is successful. So I would have to log in this user. So logging in this user means I need the email and password. Now this user is registered as a tutor. So you can see from here that the role is a tutor. Then I can come here and go to. It's a post route still, so I can come and do localhost slash login, and then come the raw JSON, and I can fill in this data so I can have the email and the password that is required. So if I send this, it says login successful, just as we expect, and then the token. Now, if the login is, let us try to maybe tamper with this. Let's maybe move I, and then let me send. So incorrect password provided, which means our check for correct password is working. Then let's use a mail that does not exist, and then let's see. So it's an email address not found. Please check your login details. So our login route is functioning fine, and we will try to grant admin access now to a user that is already logged in and is a tutor. Because it's only a tutor that can get admin access. So we go back to the code and then we do that. Okay, so it's giving me a deprecation warning that find one and update and find one and delete without use find and modify option to false are deprecated. Use find and modify, and that's what I'm using here. It's set to false already. And so I wonder why that's warning is still coming up, because that's the deprecation warning I didn't want to see. That's why I set use find and modify to false. But again, let's continue. So become admin. Now, how do you, what is, what does becoming an admin entails? Now, the person has already logged in and is trying to access an admin only route. Or we want to grant the person admin privileges. So at least the person should have logged in first. So as a tutor. And so we have to check if the person is a tutor. If the person is not a tutor, then the person should, we cannot be granted admin privileges. Now, if the person is a tutor, then we should be able to update the role of the user. So that's what we are going to be doing in become admin. So with become admin, we would like, if we are able to get the request.user, then we have to say, so if the user is not found, so if no request.user, then we can just send the message that you have to log in first. So return response status 401 and then dot send, you have to log in first. Something like that. So if there is no user detected, then we can say that. Then we can also say, now if you now get a user, so if the user request the user dot load, if the user is a tutor, then we can go on and grant admin access to the user. So we can say grant result result to this person. So find the ID and update. So we are taking the ID of the user, and then we are saying request.user.id, and we are updating the role to be admin, and then the options, use find and modify. And just set it to false, and that's all. So we have said that now what find by the and update does is the same as what you do with find one and update in MongoDB. So Mongo's just gives us a plethora of options to choose from that makes it easy to work with MongoDB. So find by the and update also does the same thing as find one and update. So it sends this as a query saying id is request.user.id and set, because if you are familiar with MongoDB query, if you are updating, you have to use a set operator to be able to do this. But in the find by the and update, you do not actually need the set operator. You can just do this and you'll still be fine. So we do this. If that is updated, then it should give us a success message that the person is now an admin. So we can say let me just pick the success message from here. So I'll paste it here, and then so at least that it has updated. So status is success. We can say message congrats, because at least to become an admin is not an easy feat. So congrats result.email. So that's from this result here, result.email. You are now an admin. So congrats is not only you are now an admin. So that's if all goes well. But again, we have to take care of the fact that it is possible that the person is not a tutor. So what if the person was an admin already? So and then okay, let us show the role. At least let us show that the update was successful. So role will be results.load. Okay. So if the person is already an admin and he's still trying to access this route, then we should be able to say request.user.load is admin. Then you just say you are already an admin, like response.status.send, like what you have here. Sorry, let me just, it's just easy to copy and paste. I think for a developer, copy and paste is so it's like second skin. So you can just say invalid request. You are already an admin, something like that. Or oops, you are already an admin. So it depends on what you want. So you can just say invalid request. You are already an admin. Sorry. Okay. All right, then if the person is not any of this, you should just say request denied because you do not have admin privileges. The quest denied. You have to be a tutor. I can customize this the same way. And probably say this email has to be a tutor. So I can just say result.email has to be a tutor. But there's so many things you can do to just customize this the way you want. So, and if there is any error, then we should be able to catch any error and say response.status 400. This. So we are able to do the logic, and what become admin majorly means is you want to make a logged in user an admin, and that user must be a tutor before you can make them an admin. So we check if the person is a tutor. If the user is not found, we have to ask them to log in for us. If the person is a tutor already, then you update their role to be admin, and then you send a message that they are not an admin. If they are admin, then there is a message for them. You're already an admin, invalid request. If if they are not an admin or a tutor, then you deny the request. So we have that. But it's not just enough to do this. We have to check for the token. And you have to check that the token is also what is in the database. So therefore, we need an authorization middleware, authentication middleware. So I could come here and do auth.js that the person has authority or is authorized to access that out. So coming here, what we basically need is the token. So I can just do const JWT is equal to require JSON web token. And once I have this required, I can also require user from our model, because we are going to be querying the database. So for models, and slash user. So we have this, and then I can say create a function auth. Let me make it an async function. And we are going to be passing three parameters. Auto function. So we have this. So we have to check if there is a token. So if there is a token, then we can go ahead with this operation. If there is no token, then we cannot go ahead with this operation yet. So we can just do something like if request dot if request dot headers remember we sent an X auth token, if it's available, or okay, that we are looking for access. So if this is provided, or we have authorization. So if we have any of this, then we can continue. Now, if we do not have, then we can have our else block. Let me just write it immediately. Yeah? So else block can be response dot return response dot status. Let us just give a forbidden because you don't have the token, so it's forbidden. Just send. So caps forbidden. I'm very sure most of you would have seen this forbidden error before. So that's that. Then let us increment the logic in our if statement. So if the token is found, then we can just say const token. Is equal to any of these two. But because we want to make it asynchronous, we can just do await or you await this. So we have that. And then let's start trying some logic. So try this and then catch any error later. Okay, so we are trying const data. DWT, we are trying to verify the token. So we want to verify that the token is the same as what we've been passing in. So token star.ng. Also, we want to verify the user. So we, if the token is found, then we can see user dot we are trying to find by token. So, and we can say if user is found, so if no user is found, you should just throw some error. Sometimes when you don't know, you can just say throw new error. The JS program would find what to do with that. Now, if user is found, then request.user is equal to user, and then token is equal to token. So you can see why we were calling request.user immediately from the middleware. Then we can see it should continue its logic, so that's why we have the parameter next. All right, then if there is any error, this should catch any error. Then we have error. I think I have so response the status. So let's give it to 401 dot send. Not authorized to access this route. And give it list source. So okay, it's not a case now, just I shouldn't have the curly brackets. So we have That is basically the authentication we do, authorization we do. So what we just said, or what we just done, is that for this, if there is a token that comes with the what's it called now, route, if there is a token in the path, then we want to access the token, and we assign that token to the variable token. Now we said that we are trying to verify the token. If this does not verify, then it doesn't go to the next. If the token is verified, then it can do find the user in the database. Now if the user is not present, then it should throw, it should say something like user not found. Was on that. Then request that user will now be the user. Actually, if the user is found, then pass the user as to request the user, and then pass the token to request the token. Then you have the code. It should continue to the next continue to the next part, or should continue executing the code. So you will see where that next comes in. I will have to export this, so we come here to do module.exports. Out. So we're exporting the function, and then we can access it anywhere within our program. So I will come here. No, sorry, not the controller or the sorry, route. Then I can create a route for the become admin. So I can do router.post, and then we can have the become admin part, or let me just say admin. Now you should check for the authorization before coming here. So that's what that next parameter does. After doing all the logic here, it should now go to the next function. So the next function is this user controller. Okay, so once we have that, we can save all files we worked on. Okay, we have an error. So you see, alt is not defined. Sorry. So I'm using it here. I've not imported it. So we can just say const alt is require. So this should not show any error again. Wants to true. So see, cannot find module out. Wow. And then what? Oh, I'm requiring it from the middleware. Pardon me. So I can kind of just, it's in a path, it's in a folder, so it didn't find it. Okay, I believe everything should be, yeah. So let's go to Postman, and then let's make some interns admin, some users admin. So we have a localhost, we have our admin path, then it is a get. I actually use a get route, so let me go back here. It's not post, it's a get. You're actually getting the actual details. Apologies. So it's router.get, not router.host. Okay, so let's go over to Postman. To get route, we have to provide authorization. So we need to sign in the user. So let's say diamond. Let me first ensure that this is signed in. So since diamond is signed in, let me copy the token because I have to provide that token. So control C, then you include that token in your part here. So authorization. So you do bear that token and then let me replace this with what I have. So with that I can send. Oh, not authorized to access this resource. That's a that this error. Where is our other JS? That is this error. So it means that the token okay. The it's a Biara token. The bearer token, let us do something, let us cons log this to the console, because that is how you can actually become better programmers, knowing how to debug and take care of errors. So don't be afraid of errors, they actually good to they ensure that you get a better knowledge of what you are doing. So let's see what token is. No, sorry, apologies. So let's come back here. I'll just do the same thing and then it's giving me the same. So okay, now you can see from the console we have a Biara in front of the token. So it's Biara EY blah blah blah, which means that it's you have to strip this Biara from the token. So what I would just have here is since it's authorization, I would do dot replace it replace Biara. And there is a space in front, so you give that space. You see it's bare space, then token start. So it replaces it with nothing. So it replaces it with nothing. So just it I've stripped it of resource. Let me do the same thing here. If this also has the token, okay. So let's save now and go back to Postman. This still the same token. Yeah, we have an error, and the error is unhandled from cannot read proper to the place of undefined. So, which one of them is undefined? Probably this first one. I guess that's what it's an X access token. It's only the authorization that should have a dot replace. So, let's do that again. Okay. Let's send now. Okay. Success. Congrats. Startadmin.com. You are now an admin. Role. Tutor. Now, that role should not be a tutor. We've already said that it should become an admin. So, you can see that the token have restricted of the bearer and the space in front at least. Let's go and check what's happening. We should not have a so I believe our X auth is fine. That's why our auth.js is fine. Then this is the result.role. Yeah, it should be the result of this query. So the role should have been ticked. So at least it's seeing the user. So I'm going to post one. I know why I keep going to that second screen. Okay, so it's seeing the email, but it's still showing a role of a tutor instead of admin. Okay, let me try to do it again and then. Oh, it means it was giving us the previous role. So it actually updated the role, but the user is now an admin. So during the same request, because it's the same token, the user is already an admin, then we cannot access that route. Remember, we have this that invalid request, you're already an admin, and that's what we have here. So that's pretty much what we needed. Let's just test a student, like a student email, I think. Let me log in. Let me log in. I think I have a dummy at gmail.com. Let me see. Okay, let's take the token. I'm not sure if this is a student or well, let's see. So let's just do this, then replace into A, into B, and then let's send. Okay, so request now you have to be a tutor. So that is a student, and then you can see that all our logic is fine. So thank you for joining me in this two-part video series of creating the logic for authorization and authentication of a user. So if time permits, I would try to do a video of how you can probably book lessons, because I think I've seen more people complain about how to go about booking a lesson for a user. So let's see if time permits, I'll do a video on that soon. So thank you and take care.